lot of people think that making your own almond milk at home is a huge daunting task, but I want to show you just how quick and easy it really is. Especially if you're somebody that reads the back of a label and you don't want any preservatives or colorants or e-flavorants or any kind of enhancers, stabilizers, whatever. You just want to know what's in your food. You can make a lot of this and then it lasts for about 6 or 7 days in the fridge. It's amazing. So the first thing that you have to do is soak your almonds. Okay, so these almonds were soaked overnight. Literally, you just soak them in regular tap water overnight. The next day, you'll see that the skins are starting to peel off. So all you do is you take an old toothbrush or a scrubbing brush and you literally scrub them clean so that they look like this. You can see they look like naked almonds, okay? The rough part of the almond has literally been scrubbed off. Okay, so they're also a little bit soft, tiny bit softer than you would normally feel an almond to be. They're normally like rock hard. So that is all you have to do. Then you take some filtered water, which I have in this bowl here. So pop your almonds in. So simple. In your water, filtered water, not tap water, the lovely spring water. A little bit of vanilla extract or vanilla essence, but preferably vanilla extract. You can add a little grind of Himalayan rock salt. If you'd prefer a slightly sweeter almond milk, like myself, you could add a little like drizzle of honey or xylitol syrup or a little bit of agave syrup or something like that. So a little bit of sweetness. So that is it. Then we're gonna blend and blend until smooth. Okay, ready and. See, it looks like almond milk. It's not really gonna get much smoother than that. There's a secret tool that you may need to get the perfect almond milk. And that is a milk sieve or a nut milk sieve, like this one. Okay, you can wash them and reuse them over and over. They're not expensive to buy. If you don't have something like this, you can use a regular sieve. Just hold it over your bowl and just push your mixture through it. But it's not going to come out as smooth. It might be a little bit more gritty and the odd little piece might go through the sieve and then you've got like a bit of a gritty almond milk, which isn't as ideal as having something super, super smooth. So if you can, get yourself a nut milk sieve, which you get from most health shops online, and you're gonna pour your mixture into that. Pour it in. Look what is left behind. It's super creamy. No lumps, no bumps. Delicious homemade almond milk. And you know what went into it. No dodgies. No surprises. You just squeeze it out a bit. A lot less harmful than milking a cow. Look at that, it's even got a beautiful froth at the top. So this milk will last about 7 days in the fridge. You can use it for everything, for your tea and coffee, your smoothies, your beautiful homemade granola, your oats. Wherever you'd normally have milk, you can rather use a homemade almond milk, even for baking. So there you go, look at that. It's got a creaminess on the top, just like farm fresh dairy milk, but obviously absolutely no lactose. If you're somebody that has a lactose intolerance and you prefer to have like a milk-free alternative or plant-based alternative, almond milk is definitely a good one. And it tastes really good, especially if you make it from scratch. A little bit of honey, remember, a little dash of xylitol salt if you prefer that kind of vibe and you've got something that lasts in the fridge for 7 days, just airtight. And it's really easy to make. Just remember, you must soak your almonds overnight. And that is it. That is the trick to making your own almond milk. Everyone thinks, oh my gosh, what do you mean make my own almond milk? I'd never do that. But when you see it happening, it's actually so simple. To make this whole process a little bit simpler and easier and more effective, just make sure that you've got the right tools. So I am using the Bosch Silent Mix blender, which is this beautiful big glass one. You can hear this glass, beautiful quality. There you go, Silent Mix. So it's definitely a little bit quieter, which is great. And it's got this big jug here, a 2.5 liter jug, which is actually really hard to find, but it's great for making like big portions. So I could have doubled this recipe and then made a much bigger jug, especially if you've got a household of four people and everybody is drinking almond milk every day, a couple of times throughout the day, you might need to make a bigger portion. So you would double or treble the recipe, the amount of almonds, the amount of water that you used, and this kind of jug blender would be able to do all of it, which is amazing, all at once. You wouldn't have to make different batches. So yeah, 2.5 liter jug, which is awesome, especially for making things like this, or for blitzing huge sort of pots of soup for the whole family. So yeah, make sure you've got the right tools because it does make your life a lot easier.